India trade deal worth £100 billion is the ultimate Brexit dividend, Boris Johnson is told. Boris Johnson has been told securing a massive trade deal with India is the ultimate Brexit dividend, and one which has the potential to rescue Western democracy in the face of China's resurgence. Daniel Hannan, officially Lord Hannan of Kingsclere, was speaking after the visit to the country by International Trade Secretary Liz Truss, during which she unveiled an enhanced trade partnership, which could pave the way for agreement some experts estimate could be worth as much as £100 billion. Writing in The Telegraph, Lord Hannan, a former Tory MEP, said if any Western country could enjoy a mutually beneficial trade deal with India, led by President Narendra Modi, it was Britain, home as it was to 1.5 million people of Indian descent. Presently, tariffs are applied by both countries to a wide range of goods – 9.6% on men's shirts entering the UK from India, for example, and 150% on whisky imported to India. Relaxation of the rules would deliver massive benefits, Lord Hannan stressed, claiming that the biggest gains would come from the liberalisation of legal and financial services. He explained. Tech, coding and engineering are among the many instances of where our economies are naturally complementary. That complementarity derives, ultimately, from the fact that India, like Britain, is an Anglophone common law, parliamentary nation, which might just prove the single most important geopolitical fact of the 21st century. The coronavirus pandemic has speeded up the shift in power from the West to China, which was the only major economy to have grown in comparison with last year. Lord Hannan added. Whether that shift also means a more authoritarian world depends largely on whether India self-defines primarily as an English-speaking democracy or as an Asian superpower. Boris Johnson, whose children Lord Hannan pointed out were partly of Indian descent, had ambitions to turn the G7 bloc into a D10, D for democracies, by including India, along with Australia and South Korea. He said. It is true that Britain's relationship with India was not always easy, and the intellectual currents that have led to statue smashing here are felt, too, on the subcontinent. Yet there is also an unmistakable affinity and affection between the two countries, an affection that the free world may yet have cause to appreciate. Writing for express.co.uk last weekend, Mrs. Truss said. There are few markets around the world that offer greater potential than India. This huge market of 1.4 billion people is already emerging as the world's fastest growing major economy and is expected to become the second biggest in the world by 2050, making it a crucial long-term trading partner. Securing new opportunities will help our businesses grow by investing in their staff and commercial future, whether it is Twinings selling tea to India, Brompton selling its bicycles, or the Dunstable Bakery exporting their naan bread.